Kingdom Kids. Hello. My name is Pastor Danny. And today, I wanted to try something new. I was told that a lot of children only pay attention when we're yelling or screaming or trying to speak loud to get your attention. But today, we want to begin worship by me whispering, and I want to show the people that our Kingdom Kids ministry can definitely pay attention when, even if I'm whispering, they can focus and worship God with all of their hearts, with all of their minds, with their eyes and their hearts focused on God. And so, would you join me together today to worship? Today is Sunday, August 8th. Let's begin with worship by lighting our candles. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." John chapter 8, verse 12. Can trust in you, God, because you are good. Amen. This month's key question is, who can trust God? And the bottom line is, I can trust in God. We can trust in God if we focus our eyes on Jesus. Our monthly memory verse comes from Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5. Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. Before we begin with our Bible story for today, who can tell me who these characters are and what these characters have in common? The first character, do you know who this is? Correct. She is Elsa from Frozen. Good. What about this character? That's Dash from The Incredibles. What about this one? That's Flash, right? He's a superhero from DC Comics. And this one. That is Superman. Now, what does these characters have in common? Can you guess? It has to do with today's Bible verse, a Bible story for today. If you have guessed, they all walked on water before, that is correct. These four characters, which are fictional characters, have all ran on water. Because of their incredible speed, they were able to all of them walk on water. Now, for today's Bible story, though these characters are fictional characters, we have a real story in the Bible that talks about walking on water. Wow! Walking on water. Today's Bible verse story comes from Matthew chapter 14, verse 22 to 33, when Jesus shows us that we can trust God. In today's Bible story, immediately Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and go ahead of him to the other side while he dismissed the crowd. After he had dismissed the crowd, he went up on a mountainside by himself to pray. Later that night, he was there alone, and the boat was already a considerable distance from the land, buffeted by the waves because the wind was against it. Shortly before dawn, Jesus went out to the disciples, walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. "It's a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. But immediately Jesus said to them, "Take courage, it is I, Jesus, do not be afraid." And so Peter said, "Lord, if it is you, tell me to come to you on the water." And so Jesus said, "Come." Then Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water towards Jesus. But when he saw the wind and the waves and the storm, he was afraid and he began to sink, crying out, "Jesus, Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus reached out his hand and caught him and said, "You of little faith, why did you doubt? Why did you not trust me? Why did you not trust God?" When they climbed into the boat, the wind died down, and those who were in the boat worshiped Jesus, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." When they crossed over, they landed at Gennesaret, and when the men of that place recognized Jesus, they sent word to all the surrounding people. First of all, from our Bible story, like the other four characters I mentioned to you before, Elsa, Dash, Flash, and Superman, who are fictional characters, we actually have two true characters, Jesus and Peter, walking on water. Wow, it's a big deal. When we read these stories, sometimes we just hear it and we just go, "Oh yeah, they did it." No, but it's a big deal when two real people can walk on water. Now, as you see, Jesus walked on water and Peter walked on water. But when Peter was walking on water, he first was able to walk on water when he put his eyes, when he stayed focused on Jesus. But as he was walking towards Jesus, as there was waves and storms, and as he probably was thinking, "Oh my goodness, I am walking on water," as he began to doubt and not trust in Jesus, he started to sink. And so from today's Bible story, our Bible story lesson is that if we put our eyes on Jesus, Jesus is showing us through this story that we can trust in God. Now, do you know why we can put our trust in God? Do you know why we can trust Jesus? Is it just because he walked on water? No. Do you know what is more surprising and even more miraculous than Jesus and Peter walking on water? Is that Jesus walks on land. Jesus, who is God, walks on earth among us. That is an amazing, the craziest, most awesome good news ever, that God would become human to walk on land with us. And that truth is even greater than walking on water. Now, walking on water is cool because not everyone, no human being, because of gravity, can walk on water. But the reason why we can trust in Jesus is because Jesus is God. Jesus is God, and as a human being, he is reminding us that we can trust in God if we put our eyes on if we stay focused on God and Jesus. Now, our monthly verse is what? Trust in the Lord with all of your heart. With all of your heart. With all of your heart. Don't just trust in the outside. Don't act like you can trust, but trust in your heart and in everything that you do. Through life, sometimes it's hard to trust God all the way. That is why we need our brothers and sisters, our parents, our pastors and teachers to guide us, to help us to learn how to trust in God. But like Peter, there are many times where as we are walking to Jesus or walking this journey of life, we forget to put our eyes on God. And as we think as we trust in more on ourselves and what we do, like Peter, we can begin to sink. There are things in life, whether it's school, whether it's maybe riding a skateboard or your bicycle, or maybe even doing sports. In the beginning, we pray this prayer, God, help me to get on that team. Help me to make friends. Help me to get an A on that test. Help me to build a good relationship with mom and dad. We pray these prayers in the beginning, trusting that God will answer our prayers and fulfill his promises. But as we go along the journey, we forget about the prayers we made. And when things are, we're doing well or we succeed in life, we slowly do not focus our eyes on God, but start to rely and put more trust on ourselves, thinking that I can do it. I made it. Yes, it's important that you can do it because through God, he's the one who gave you strength. But it is not right to think that only you, because of you, you made it this far. And so it's a great reminder through our story today that we need to put our trust, our eyes, and stay focused on God, on Jesus, who is God in this world. And because we trust God doesn't mean that we're going to walk on water. But like walking on water, there are a lot of things in this world that can break easily, that's hard for us to fully trust or to depend on. And as we walk this journey, whatever hardships you're going through, especially through this past year and a half, as we now prepare to go to school, some of us might be really afraid of COVID-19, of making friends, of going back into real life after being virtual or on a computer. But if we just focus on those things, it's like Peter who's focusing on him, the waves and the storms and him walking on water, all these things with doubt. Instead of focusing on those things, let's go back to God. Let's ask God, God, I cannot do this by myself. But with you, through you, with the brothers and sisters and family, pastors, teachers that you blessed our lives with, I think I can do it. I think because of you, Jesus, because I'm trusting in God, because I'm staying focused in God, I think with this renewed strength, as I take courage, I can do all things if I put everything, my whole trust in God. And so my hope and prayer and the little nugget, little lesson that you got, remember, right? As I'm whispering, as you're focused, as people say, you have to scream or yell at the kids to get their attention. I pray and hope, even though I'm whispering, just like that, as we put our trust in God, that we'll be able to accomplish anything, to not be afraid, and to be brave and courageous, bold and courageous, and to do everything that God has called us to do. I really believe our Kingdom Kids ministry, through all the challenges that has already happened, as we look into the new chapter, the new school year, new fall season, I know that we are stronger than ever, that we are more resilient, we are more tougher, and we can now move forward with anything. We could accomplish anything because what we went through. And so my hope and prayer is that each and every one of you will put our eyes and focus on God, and with God, we move forward. With God, we trust God. We stay focused on God, and we do what God has called us to do, which is to go and tell people, to go tell this world of the love of God through His Son, Jesus Christ. We pray for that blessing. Amen. Let us pray. My mother told me that before we pray, she used to always say, 믿음, 소망, 사랑. What that means in English is faith, hope, and love. And then we got into a posture of prayer. So let's pray. Closing our eyes, putting our hands together with our head bowed. Let's pray. Father, we thank you so much for today. We pray that our Kingdom Kids, through the Bible story and the memory verse of today, to trust in God with all of our hearts, as Jesus has shown us through this Bible story of Peter and Jesus walking on water, as Jesus shows us that we can put our trust in God, help us to put our eyes, to stay focused on you, Jesus, to put our hope, our everything on you, God. As we trust in you, remind us that we can accomplish anything, that we will be just fine because of you, God, because you have everything in your hands, everything under control as we put our trust in you. So we pray that our Kingdom Kids will be able to fully put our trust in you as we live out into another week, another month, into a new season. Be with us. Remind us that you are with us. We ask for your blessing to be poured upon this place. We thank you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now we will have a time of offering. As you heard the message, as you receive it into your hearts, a time of offering now is to lift up our hearts, to lift up the representation, the money or the gifts that you have, to lift up to God as an act of offering. Let's give our offering to God.
And forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, power, and the glory forever. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Thank you for leading us in Lord's Prayer for this week. Thank you so much once again for allowing me to worship with you guys. I'm so blessed to know you and to be able to worship with you. We ask that you continue to keep all the pastors and teachers and Kingdom Kids Ministry, our KUMCGW Greater Washington Church, all in your prayers. as we continue to prepare and transition into the fall season from summer to the fall. And so please continue to keep us in prayer. We're going to now end this time of worship with a new praise song titled, I'm Gonna Tell. I'm gonna tell everyone, everywhere. And so blessings as we end our service with this praise.
It's a beautiful day. I wanna celebrate. I wanna tell everyone. I just can't wait. He is my friend. He is so great. He can do anything. I just can't wait. Everyone, I just can't wait.